Let's talk a little more about this, because with me in the studio is John Hemmings, director of the Asia Studies Centre at the Henry Jackson Society. That's a think tank that advocates the robust spreading of liberal democracy. And John, it's good to have you with us. Thank you very much.
Thank you. What's
going on here in terms of America's response to North Korea?
Well, of course, I mean, the redesignation of North Korea as a terrorist state is probably more important than it first seems. That will enable the administration to really crunch down on those institutions and financial organizations and various actors around Southeast Asia, in China, that are still allowing the North Korean regime to kind of slip by. It's not as under sanction pressure as most people think.
So where's there room, in your view, for maneuver there? Where's the room to act a little more robustly?
As the Trump administration has, I think, correctly pinpointed, it's on the North Korean and China border. There's still a significant amount of trade. There's still a history of even weapons sales. There's North Korean actors in China who are still buying things and bringing them over. And so we need to see a significant shift in that. If you look at the satellite data, you can see the truck still going. Now, there is talk about shortages of fuel and so on. But remember, as recently as last year, there was talk about a building boom in Pyongyang. It was the Manhattan.
Yeah.
And so I think people who think that we've sanctioned this country simply don't know that sanctions haven't really been given a try.
What's your thoughts on the way that China is playing this? Because clearly President Trump is keen to say that he has established a good rapport with the Chinese president. Is it possible for people to say today, on the basis of what's going on, Chinese aren't really doing anything? They're saying the right things, but they're not doing anything. Is that fair?
It is fair, but I think we should still continue to work with China. They are the key to resolving this issue peacefully. It's understandable in some ways that the Chinese do not want to see a reunified South Korea allied with the United States on their border. You know, it would be a bit of a security nightmare for them. So they really do prefer the status quo. And they're also equally worried about a collapse of North Korea in which they, you know, the sanctions work too well. Mm-hmm. And we see the regime collapse and huge amounts of refugees flooding across the border. What we have to do is find that sweet spot. The sweet spot we found with Libya, the sweet spot we found with South Africa. When sanctions were applied enough on the political elites of a country to make them change their behavior and at least get the North Koreans back to the table.
Why is it proving so difficult to find that so-called sweet spot?
Well, I think the North Koreans are incredibly well attuned to shifts and changes in Western democracies. Every 4 years, there's a new negotiating team. We've also dropped the ball a few times, but there's been hundreds of negotiating efforts since the 1990s. I mean, literally hundreds. So it's not for want of trying. It's, to some extent, the regime type, their insular nature, their dependency on a very bizarre form of Stalinist ideology. And also to the geopolitical elements, the way that China and North Korea relate to each other and to the South.
A thought just to end on, if I can, John, on
sure.
The options that some people have canvassed in terms of military action. Do you ever think that it'll come to that?
Well, a very recent report by RUSI, the think tank, said that we have to be ready that war could occur. Of course, it's a nightmare scenario. One hopes that it doesn't happen. But the fact is that political leaders in Japan, in South Korea, and in Washington will be thinking about that as a possible eventuality and hopefully not one that occurs.
John, good to talk to you.
Thank you
for coming in. Thanks very much. John Hemmings there for us, director of the Asia Studies Centre at the Henry Jackson Society. Good to have you.